brought to you by Penguin.
The Career Change Guide, written and read by me, Rachel Schofield. This book is dedicated to my own band of career change cheerleaders, Jeremy, Martha, and Anna, who believed in me when my courage wobbled. And for any other mums who sometimes need reminding who they really are and what they're capable of. Introduction. So tell me, just how long have you been thinking about a career redesign? A few months? A couple of years? A decade? Does it sneak up on you on holiday when your mind finally has time to wander? After a crappy day in the office when you've sold more pointless widgets and your ideas have gone unnoticed? Maybe when your surly teen rolls their eyes at yet another meal you've slaved over and you wonder if it's time you went back to work? Or perhaps as you hit like on a friend's LinkedIn post and notice an uncomfortable twinge of jealousy. Of course, we all have days when we idly dream of a new life, but this is different. The career thoughts and ideas that regularly rattle around your brain inspire, terrify, and muddle you all at the same time. You've probably tried the patience of your partner and friends with your constant talk of change and your utter inability to take action. Perhaps you've made a few half-hearted attempts to get started, but soon backed off, full of more doubt and questions than excitement and motivation. You've become a serial Googler of training courses, solopreneurs, or career pivots. Sound familiar? If you're wondering how the A-level choices you made 10 years ago have led you down a career path you feel you never really chose, if you're reassessing your future now you're a parent with new priorities and different ambitions, if you're sensing an opportunity to reinvent yourself as your kids are growing up and it's finally you time, if the global pandemic has shaken your world and is pushing you towards change, then this book is for you. The wonderful people I coach all have their own individual career stories, but it's fair to say they have three things in common. One, they feel they've somehow lost sight of who they really are. Two, they want to create a working life that feels meaningful and fulfilling, but they're unsure what that looks like or how to get there. And three, they're excited and motivated some days and hit by rocky confidence and self-doubt the next. Sound like you? I thought so. Because my knowledge of what goes on in the heads of career changers doesn't just come from working with my clients. It comes from my own personal experience of that strange roller coaster ride that is a career change. Let me briefly share my story with you. Before making my very own career pivot, I reported and presented for the BBC for over 20 years. Starting out as a keen young reporter for local TV and radio, I moved to Radio 4's You and Yours and Woman's Hour, and then spent more than a decade presenting for the organisation's flagship 24-hour news channel. I was full-time, part-time, and freelance, changing my work to fit around our family and reassessing what worked and what didn't after both of my year-long maternity leaves. I'm married, and our two daughters are now teenagers. When it felt like there was too much that wasn't working, practically and in terms of my own job fulfillment, I did what you're doing. I started investigating. I knew I wasn't inspired. I was fed up with antisocial shifts and felt a little bit unseen as a small freelancer in a huge machine. I knew I still enjoyed asking questions, analysing responses and digging for truth, but I was tired of asking questions people tried to avoid answering, and I was looking for something more collaborative to replace the combative nature of political debate. I knew I wanted a change, and it needed to be bigger than working as a journalist in another guise. But I was also scared of getting it wrong and parting company with an internationally respected organisation which I'd been proud to call home since I was 21. What else could I do with the skills I had? What should I do? What did I want to do? How would I make it happen? And, horror of horrors, how would I explain it in a way that was credible to other people? Working that out took time, energy, and honesty. It led me to where I am now, a a fully qualified personal development and career coach, using the techniques and framework I was trained in and my own journey to support others. But first, I had to do exactly what I'm about to help you to do. Deal with all the negative voices in my own head. Figure out who I really was. In my case, after 2 children and 2 decades in 1 industry. Get clear on my purpose. Work out which of my ideas made most sense and felt most promising. Then transition from one role to another. For me, that meant embarking on some formal retraining, rebranding myself, and establishing and growing my own coaching business. I'm delighted to accompany you on this journey and find out what it means for you. This book is designed to take you from the confusion and indecision that stops you doing anything to a clearer picture of the kind of work and life you actually want, and then to give you a roadmap to make it a reality. It's going to take you on a structured 5-step career redesign journey. Preparing, then reflecting, imagining and designing, on to taking action, and finally, keeping going. First, we'll get your fickle brain in gear and equip you to become a committed career redesigner. Then you'll reflect on your greatest strengths and skills, what lights you up and what motivates you, to get clear on what meaningful and satisfying work is going to look like for you. Thirdly, you'll generate and prioritise ideas and explore the resulting career options, designing ways to put them to the test. Next, you'll create a proper action plan for whatever future you decide on, and you'll finish by supercharging your mindset to ensure you see it through, with insights and advice from people who've already made their own career changes, whether great or small. Each step is packed with thought-provoking exercises to increase your self-awareness, clarity, and confidence, along with practical insights on how to tackle the day-to-day challenges of a career redesign. Okay, enough procrastination. Are you ready to discover your dream job? Step 1, preparing. Before we start, there are a few things we need to tackle head on, because I suspect you've made a few attempts to start this journey before, and you've become stuck. You've felt demoralised, you've run out of steam. So let's make sure that this time you pack the right kit for what can, at times, feel like a bumpy journey. It's tempting to skip this bit. Oh, let's just get stuck in, I hear you thinking. But that's where you've gone wrong before. So trust me, and stick with it. Chapter 1. Time to get off your butt. If there's one massive obstacle in your way, it's you. Or, more specifically, your own brain. It's like you're in a tug of war with yourself. On one side is your ambitious, creative, adventurous self, pulling hard towards change and nurturing those thoughts of a more fulfilling work life. Yanking back is your risk-averse, status-quo-loving alter ego, fearful of the unknown and desperate to keep you safe and comfortable. For every idea you tug at, your brain pulls back control with a big list of why it just won't work. The result of this epic tug of war? Your dreams lose. You're forever falling on your butt. I'd love to return to the arts, but I sometimes wonder if I could start my own business, but I dream of becoming an accountant, but okay, so no one has ever said that to me. Yet. So what is going on? Predominantly our own biology. Neuroscientists will tell you that we're hardwired to resist uncertainty, so much so that our brain prefers a predictable negative outcome over an uncertain one. Our natural default is to stay put, where our brain is confident it knows what's coming and how to handle it. So no wonder you have a tendency to conclude that a career move would be a disaster and jog on, rather than wrestle with the unknown. Change is certainly challenging. It can seem scary and risky. A career change or redesign, doubly so, tied up as it is with our identity and our status, our finances, our family life, and our friendships. Nope, says your brain, let's just not go there. Bored and unchallenged, you may be, but at least you're safe. Because safety is one of your brain's main priorities. However, in the relative comfort of the 21st century, your well-meaning mind...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.